Everyone, let's start. Practice 3.2, question number 10. Determine whether each of the following holds for the given operation. See now, in this first question, the set of r whole numbers for multiplication.
Even whole number. So for these also what you are going to
yes, determine whether each of the following close for the given operation. So this is close for the given operation. Again, we are getting which number? Again, even whole number. If you do 4 into 6, 6, 4, 6 are 24. Again, we are getting even whole number. Yes. So here we come. Yes. Then the set of whole numbers less than 1000 for multiplication. The set of whole numbers less than 1000, which numbers are less than 1000? That you multiply. Yes, and that is close for given operation or not, that you have to find. Okay, means again you are going to get the whole number. So this will also come, yes. So you try with the different examples. So I am not going to give these. You have to try with using different examples. Okay, you can use here different examples. And the next, the set of whole numbers greater than 1000 for multiplication. Greater than 1000, which numbers? Any two numbers you take greater than 1000 and multiply that, again you are going to get the number, whole number. Yes, so that is also close for the given operation. So here it will also come. Yes, so see now, three examples I have shown. Three examples you have to take your own example and you have to write the answer. Let's solve question number 11. Product of two whole numbers is 0. Product of two whole numbers is 0. Can you comment on the nature of whole number? See now, what it is given? Product of two whole numbers. Any two whole numbers. What it is? Product. Product means answer in multiplication is called product. And what it is given? 0. Product of two whole numbers is 0. So, in this, what it should be? One number must be 0. In this, what we should write here? One number must be 0. And other number should be 0 or any other whole number. Other number should be 0 or any another number. Okay? If you will take 0 multiplied by 0, you are going to get answer 0. You will take 0 multiplied by any another whole number. 3, 0 into 3, 0. Yes, any another whole number, if you will take 4, what you are going to get? Answer 0. 0 into 125, what you are going to get? Answer 0. So now what comment you can write on this? One number must be 0 and second number should be 0 or any whole number. Okay, so here we'll write comment. One number must be 0. See, here I have given one of the example. You can take any example and you can write here. Okay. One number must be 0 and other number should be 0 or any whole number. One number must be 0 and other number should be 0 or any whole number. Any whole number you can take here. Understood? So product of two whole number is 0. Can you comment on the nature of the whole number? One number must be 0 and other number should be 0 or any whole number. Let's solve question number 12. For a whole number A, A multiplied by A is equal to A, then write the value of A. Then write the value of A. A multiplied by A is equal to A. We'll see. A means now C. Here which number will take, then we are going to get the number itself. See, A into A is equal to A. Suppose if you will take 2 into 2, suppose A you consider 2, this A also 2. So are you taking again 2? Okay. So are you going to get the answer again to no? We are going to get answer 4.